Good afternoon. Good afternoon. I was reminded by our organist, Minister of Music, John Vida, that it's a little after three. That there's always that teacher in him, you know. So in any event, my name is Bob Zanicki. I'm the pastor of the First Presbyterian Church, and I welcome you on behalf of the church, and we're just so pleased that you have come out on this dreary day to be inspired. And so we welcome you. Before I forget also, please silence your cell phones. If you haven't done that, please do so. Okay. Somebody brought it to my attention, which I hadn't done this, but about maybe wanting to make a donation in honor of this event, and it would go to the music program. So I placed a small basket in the back there. If you are so moved, please feel free to make that donation, and it'll go toward, again, the music program. Let's see. Following the service, we will have a reception that includes champagne, okay? I should say maybe only 4 ounces each or something or whatever. But in any event, we have that, and we have some other goodies. So right through the doors, especially that door there, straight through into the fellowship hall, following the event, the concert, you are all invited to attend. Restrooms, there's a single restroom through that door there, a little further down, and then into the parlor over there. Go through that door to your right, a little more to the right in the parlor, and in the corner right, you'll see the ladies' restroom, okay? We do have a couple deacons in the back. They could be of some help, perhaps, for some of the reasons. Well, I think I've taken care of what I've needed to do. So I'd like to now introduce Jeff Davidowitz, who will come up and welcome you and tell us a little more.
Reverend Zanicki, Rabbi, my family who's here, and friends. Are you Essie's son? This was a common question when meeting someone new. My mother embodied the Jewish concept of tikkun olam, which means the healing of the world. For my mother, that meant she would reach out and touch people's lives. Whether it was a few kind words to a distressed cashier, teaching life lessons while running a GIMP program at camp, or paving the way to go to medical or pharmacy school, even raising the funds for a concert harpist to buy a new harp. That is Gulia, who was also Megan's teacher and my mother's teacher. No project was too big or too small. Many of us here have been on one side of that process, either as a recipient or as an enabler in some way. My mother was happy to call on all of us to help participate in her good deeds. She was a lifelong learner who had an appreciation of music and art. She grew up in an art-inspired home in Hazleton. As a trustee of Wilkes, she worked with Al Groh to build the Dorothy Dixon Dart Center. My family is grateful that you have provided such a beautiful home for the harp. I know my mother would be pleased. Thank you, Reverend Zanicki, and your staff who made today possible. A special thank you to Megan and Alex, who are here with us this evening and will be performing on both my mother's harp and on Megan's harp, and Alex will be playing the cello. They had a very special place in my mother's heart, and they make beautiful music. My prayer, since this is where we are, is that the music from the harp speak to you and bring you comfort and peace as my mother provided to us. Thank you.
generously donated her Salvi Daphne pedal harp to the First Presbyterian Church, and it could not have found a better home. Thank you to Reverend Zanicki and John Vida for having us today. It's truly an honor. We have just performed The Swan by Saint-Saëns, and we have two other classical selections for you. The first will be the Schubert Ave Maria, and then that will be followed by Debussy's Clair de Lune. Thank you. and I were actually married 9 years ago, just down the road at St. Stephen's Church. And when we got married, we decided that we'd like to share our music with our loved ones, and we recorded our very first album called The Nearness of You. And it was a really wonderful project. We enjoyed doing it very, very much. So the next three selections on the program are from that album, starting with Songbird by Christine McBee. She was in Fleetwood Mac. And our version is particularly inspired by the Eva Cassidy cover of the song, which is very famous and very, very beautiful. And that will be followed by It Had to Be You from the Great American Songbook. And finally, the title track from our album, The Nearness of You. Thank you. harps are very finicky, if you haven't noticed. Thank you for your patience. It's not the pale moon that excites me. When we recorded the Nearness of You album, we never expected that it would take 8 years for our next album, but that's what happens when Alex was back in school. We moved from Pennsylvania to Virginia. We had 3 children, so life kind of happened, but during COVID, we ended up watching the show Outlander. I don't know if any of you are familiar with it. The theme song is called The Skyboat Song, and it's about Bonnie Prince Charlie and his adventure going from Scotland to the Isle of Skye, and his escape from the British. I heard the song and I was really struck with it, and I was inspired to write an arrangement of it, and we ended up recording it and putting it up on YouTube, and it got the attention of a festival in North Carolina, an Outlander festival that features actors from the show that come on. come to the festival to present, and they said, would you come and give a concert? And I said, absolutely. Problem, we don't have any Scottish music. And the show is based in Scotland and very much inspired by that. So I got to work writing a Scottish program, and it also has selections from the show itself. And we decided to record the album, and we released it last January. So we were really excited about that. So the next series of songs on the program is directly from that album, and starting with, of course, the Skyboat song. Sing me a song of a lass that is gone. Say, could that lass be I? Mary of souls, she sailed on a day over the sea to sky. Mull was her stern, rum on the port, egg on the starboard bow. Glory of youth glowed in her soul. Where is that glory now? Sing me a song of a lass that is gone. Say, could that lass be I? Mary of souls, she sailed on a day over the sea to sky. Give me again all that was there. Give me the sun that shone. Give me the eyes, give me the soul. Give me the lass that's gone. Sing me a song of a lass that is gone. Say, could that lass be I? Mary of souls, she sailed on a day over the sea to sky. Billow and breeze, islands and seas, mountains of rain and sun, all that was good next song on the program is also from our Skyboat Song album, and it's called The Northern Lights of Old Aberdeen. And this song felt particularly fitting to include in today's program because it's all about missing home and coming home. And I grew up in Dallas, and it feels so great to be back and to perform for all of you today. It's also, it might not seem like this song would also be important for this reason, but my piano teacher growing up was Sukasa Waltich, who many of you might know. She and her husband, in addition to being incredible musicians, they're also astronomy enthusiasts. And so they go out with their telescopes and they stargaze, and I also became very interested in that. We had wonderful memories together looking at meteor showers and stars and all kinds of things. The one day we decided to go to Keystone College, their observatory was having a stargazing night. And wouldn't you believe it, but we were treated to the most magnificent display of the Northern Lights, the one and only time I've ever experienced that, and it was beyond words. So this song about the Northern Lights and coming home just felt right. that spoke o'er her, but now she.
For Should old acquaintance be forgot and never brought to mind? Should old acquaintance be forgot for old lang syne? For old lang syne, my dear, for old lang syne, we'll take a cup o' kindness yet for
much. So the previous two sets, that was music that came from our two albums, which we've already released. And then the music from this point on is music that we would love to eventually put on maybe a third album. Starting with Danny Boy. I have strong Irish roots, so this is particularly meaningful to me and my family. It was my grandfather's favorite song, so I hope you enjoy it. Oh, Danny boy, the pipes are calling from glen to glen and down the mountain side. The sun come in. during the pandemic, it was such a difficult time for so many people. And it particularly hit musicians very, very hard. A lot of us were out of a job basically overnight. So Alex and I discussed it, and we decided that we were gonna use the time and really focus on the music that was important to us, recording it, and then making music videos and releasing them on YouTube. And then something unexpected happened even after that. I began writing music, something I never imagined that I would do. And this was the first song I ever wrote. It's very special, it's about our children, and it's about the promises that we make to them. And it's even more special because, I'm sorry, Essie heard this song. Her family played it for her. And so this is the one and only song, original song of mine that Essie has heard, but it will forever be special because of that. It's called I'll Lift You Up. Tiny fingers, tiny toes, unimaginably tiny little nose. Your eyes open, then I'm lost. I'll protect you. To an imperfect There's definitely a nautical theme to the next two selections. The next song is one of my favorites, Van Morrison's Into the Mystic. And then that will be followed by another original about being a wayfarer and having the sea call to you. And the ironic thing about that is I get seasick. But, you know, I've always been fascinated with the sea, and I just think it's a really interesting topic to write about. So I hope you enjoy both of these nautical selections.
Thank you.
Thank you.
switch harps now. There's the whole story about how Essie and I came to meet, and how I came to be her teacher, and how our friendship really evolved and then blossomed. So please take a minute to read it if you haven't already. It'll give you a really great understanding of our deep love for each other, and of also how this harp came to be in Essie's hands and the amazing lineage that it went through, including Nancy Allen, principal harpist of the New York Philharmonic, and Gulia Masharova, and to me, and then to Essie. So we lost Essie almost 2 years ago, and if you told me that I wouldn't be able to be by her side, I would just have been so in disbelief about that, because there's no other place I would have rather have been than with her in her final days and at her service. But if I were fortunate enough to have been at Essie's service and performed for it, I would have chosen to perform this next song, Imparidissum. It is absolutely glorious, and it reminds me of heaven, which I know that's where Essie is. So I hope you enjoy this final song. Thank you so much for coming today, to bearing witness to Essie's incredible legacy, and to celebrate the gift of this beautiful harp to First Presbyterian Church. Thank you so much.
Thank you. join us for some refreshments, and I'm sure they would be happy to talk to you and to tell them how much you enjoyed this class. Thank you. Yes, right through the door there.